Hey guys, and welcome to my second annual Fright Night. This is actually night number one. Just as last year, all of the movies from my 13 Nights of Fright will be first time watches. If you are interested, I'm gonna go ahead and link that playlist up here so you can check out the movies that I saw last year. So on with this review. Tonight we're gonna be talking about 1992's Bram Stoker's Dracula. Let's let the loud truck pass by. Now this movie is adapted from 1897's Dracula, written by Bram Stoker. I have not listened to this book quite yet myself. For my new viewers, I am definitely an Audible lover. I just do not have the attention span to read it. Now this movie was actually nominated for 4 Academy Awards, and it won 3 of them for best makeup, costume design, and sound editing. Now this film does have a wonderful cast. We're gonna start off with Winona Ryder, who plays Mina Murray. She's actually the one that brought the script for Capella, who is the director and the producer of the movie. Even though it was a little bit iffy because she thought that the director didn't like her because she did have to withdraw from The Godfather Part 3 just because of health issues, which ultimately ended up in production delays. But Capella did fall in love with this story. We also have Keanu Reeves. He plays Jonathan Harker. He is like this real estate agent. He is somebody who has a terrible accent, English accent, in this film.
I've seen many strange things already. Bloody wolves chasing me through some blue inferno.
Now Christian Slater was actually offered this role of Jonathan, but he ended up turning it down, and of course later on in life ended up really regretting doing so. Gary Oldman plays Dracula, and Sir Anthony Hopkins plays Professor Van Helsing. There, I thought again of an action was gonna come on. I don't know what's wrong with me tonight, you know? Now, the director was actually pretty insistent on no contemporary kind of like special effects, like any kind of CGI to be used within the film. Instead, he really wanted to use like the effects that were used in like historical cinema, just like back in the day, just to really kind of fit the time period that we were in. He just didn't want any kind of modern technology to be used. Capella had actually hired like a whole visual effects team, and when he was letting them know like his wishes on what he wanted to be done with the film, they pretty much told them, no, this can't be done the way that you want it to be done. It has to be done with like these modern technology. It has to be done with CGI. And Capella didn't like that. He's all like, he was a visionary and he knew this, these things could be done, but apparently they could not be done with this specific team. So he said, sayonara, you guys. And he ended up firing that team, and he brought on his son. Now Roman, who is the son, was actually able to achieve what his father wanted to do. All the visuals in the movie were actually achieved without any kind of like optical or CGI effect, but created with using on-set and in-camera methods. The movie is not scary, you guys. It is more of a love story. So if you are looking for like a horror romance movie this spooky season to kind of like curl up next to with your loved one, then you may want to give this one a watch. It is a long one though, which is one of my major negatives on the film, because I could definitely feel the length of the movie. I wish it was definitely shorter. I unfortunately was just not a fan of the movie. It was just extremely long. I could not get past Keanu Reeves' acting, or lack of acting ability, in this movie, you guys. As much as I love him,
the man himself. Look, he's grown young.
He was definitely the weakest link. Anthony Hopkins is Anthony Hopkins, and he's like obviously like wonderful and everything. Gary Oldman also, I feel like he gave Dracula like a little something. I don't know, like he really gets into his characters. He does tend to always have a lot of makeup and prosthetics, and he really transforms himself, or they transform him rather, for his roles. And this one is definitely no exception from where he's like old as wrinkly cringly Dracula to where he's like this very handsome, very good looking Count Dracula. Or even at the beginning when we take place like early on back in the day when he's like fighting in the war. And we're gonna get that here in just a little bit, because I totally bypassed the plot of the movie. So in 1462, yes you guys, we are in the 14th century, one Vlad Dracula, well, he comes home from a victory against the Turks. He's ready to see his wife get some loving, because this movie is very, very sensual, you guys. Well, it's not quite the welcome home he was expecting. Unfortunately, his beloved Elizabeth, who is played by Winona Ryder as well, ends up killing herself because she ends up receiving this message from the enemy that her beloved has died at war. It was obviously a lie, and she just could not imagine a world without her precious blood. He's obviously devastated, and the priest, who's also played by Sir Anthony Hopkins, doesn't make it any better when he tells Vlad, or Dracula rather, she's called, well, technically at this point he's still Vlad. He pretty much ends up telling him that your beloved is gonna go straight to hell. She is damned because she took her own life. Now, this does not sit very well with Vlad, and he ends up losing shit, guys. He ends up desecrating the chapel. He ends up stabbing like this, like cross stone, whatever, and apparently this stone was full of blood, and the, you know, it's pouring down. He ends up renouncing God, and he starts saying that he, when he dies, he's gonna rise from the grave. He's gonna get his beloved, and I don't know, like vengeance, right? And he ends up like drinking the blood, and hence is the start of Dracula. There goes the accent again, Dracula, and then that's how Dracula becomes who he is. Then we flash forward to 1897. One solicitor, Jonathan Harker, ends up taking on Count Dracula as his client. Now, Jonathan is dating Mina, who again is played by Winona Ryder, and they're not quite yet engaged. He says, you know what, babe, I'm gonna go do this job. You stay here, you're gonna wait for me. When he leaves the picture on the table, Dracula ends up finding the photo, and it's like, oh, it's my beloved Elizabeth. Like, what are you doing? Well, no, he doesn't go all dramatic like I am. He just like sees the photo, and he is now on a mission to find his beloved Elizabeth / Mina and like woo her back to him. So again, it is a love story, you guys. Now again, it is rated R because there are like sexy times. Well, is there sexy time happening? Yeah, like with Lucy, who is Mina's friend. Sadie Frost plays Lucy, and apparently they could only afford one of her boobs because she is exposed, just like her top. But every time you only see the one boob. Before I do give you my overall thoughts and my score, if you haven't already, go ahead and give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. And of course, don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified each time that I post something new, or so you can continue to get notified for the remaining 12 nights of Fright, you guys. Overall, even though I was not generally a fan of the movie overall, technically speaking, it is a very stunning movie. Visually, it's great as well. And sound, the sound mixing, the score is absolutely wonderful. It's more mainly like the story overall and like acting also. I just really wasn't here for it as well. Costume also was really good. So with that, I cannot fully recommend this for you, but of course if it's something that you're into, then totally go for it. It is very, very beloved, you guys. Really, really beloved. So that could maybe like get you into wanting to watch it. I just really don't see myself rewatching it. So with that said, I'm gonna give it a small popcorn. If you've seen Bram Stoker's Dracula, let me know down below, what did you think about it? Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Was it just not for you? If you've never seen this movie, is it something that you're maybe looking to check out? Again, it is a love story, and it's also a horror movie. Like, not really, because like I said, I can watch it. I never got scared. Wait, did I get scared? You know what? I got scared in a funny part, because I think it tells you like the dates, if I recall correctly. Were there dates here? I feel like there were. I hope I'm not mistaken it with another movie that had like a date on there. Anywho, if this is a movie that had a date coming out, when that date came on and it had like a dramatic sound to it, I went, oh, that scared me, you guys. Shouldn't have scared me, but that like, it spooked me rather. That's it for me tonight. I'll see you tomorrow for, I'm not sure yet what movie. I haven't officially made the schedule as I'm pre-recording this, but I will work on that tonight. All right guys, till next time, I'll see you guys at concessions. Bye.